Can I ask you one more time, like you believe in heaven and believe in Christmas miracles? I want you to put your hands together, give a big praise to the Lord tonight. And let's kick this thing off saying, Lord, you are alive in this place. Let's worship Him.
Come on and put your hands together. Jesus is born and He's alive. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
to clap your hands. I'm glad you're standing up, because I'm going to make you stand up. If you're not sitting down, I need you to stand up and sing the song with us. It says, Jesus is the reason for the season. Say, Jesus is the reason for the season. Jesus is the reason for the season. Here we go. It's kind of funky. Here we go.
Jesus is the reason for the season, yeah.
cross, take a little step of faith, that somebody would say, you know, that's me tonight. I think I'm going to go up to the cross. Jesus said, whoever comes to me, I will in no wise cast them out. Who's the first one tonight to say, you know what? I need a Christmas miracle. Come on, walk. Take a walk of faith right now. I don't care if you're sitting in the back of the church. Take a faithful walk right now. Come on. I tell you, I've seen a whole lot of miracles when people would just come up to their altar and take a little step of faith and say, what do I have to lose? I gotta ask you, what do you have to lose? Get a little closer. I think there's some more people about ready to come up here. And listen, I want those of you out there in the congregation, I want you to turn on the left and on the right and reach out to somebody on Christmas Eve night and say these words. Can I go to the cross with you? Come on, do it right now. Come on, do it. Can I go to the cross with you? If they say yes, walk up with them. Come on, right now. Come on, reach out and just help somebody on Christmas Eve. Why don't you take a chance? Just believe. She said all things are possible. How many know that all things are possible? Raise your hand up right now, and then I'm going to start praying. Come on, raise your hand up. You believe all things are possible. That means somebody with cancer could get well. That means somebody on drugs could get delivered. Come on, more people are coming up here. That means somebody with a messed up home life that Jesus could get up in the middle of your house tonight. And while you're in church worshiping God, God can do a turnaround just in time for Christmas. Come on, somebody feel what I'm saying. Somebody come up to the cross tonight and tell the devil, enough is enough. Because I'm coming to the manger tonight. Oh, hallelujah. Let's take our hands, everybody in the house of God. Let's stretch it out. Come on, everybody. We're in this thing together. And I'm going to pray. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, we feel there is a movement of faith. And Lord, I'm glad tonight on Christmas Eve, we don't have to have a lot of faith. Somebody in here tonight says, I don't even think I have faith. But the good news is the Bible said that every man and woman is given the measure of faith. And you only need faith the size of a grain of mustard seed. So with your hand out to the cross right now, I want you to, everybody to say these two words, say, I believe. Come on, say it. A little bit louder, say, I believe. A little bit louder, one more time, say, I believe. Come on, say it. With your hand out right now, we ask that Jesus take this nail-scarred head. It's not the size of a baby anymore, because at the age of 33, he died on the cross for all our sins. Take that hand and stretch it out to the nail-scarred hand of Jesus. Devil, right now, we take authority over you in Jesus' name. Satan, you think you can hold the people down tonight? You think you can sow your doubts and unbelief? But right now, we resist the devil. We resist the lies. We resist hopelessness. We resist everything that the devil will try to bring us down with this Christmas. And we reach out with our hand and say, Jesus, do miracles tonight. God, heal that person sick in their body. We rebuke that cancer in the name of Jesus. We take authority over that disease that the medicine can only treat, but Dr. Jesus can cure. Be healed in Jesus' name. Be healed not only in your body, but healed in your mind. Glory to God. Somebody's getting peace this Christmas right now. The body, the mind, God, I'm asking you to work out the details. God, somebody has had a year of like, God, what is going on? God, it seems like I'm going nowhere fast. But I'm here to tell you that God has a plan. You may not understand it, but if you'll stretch your hand out in faith, he's about to lead you somewhere. God, I thank you that as we close out the year, the doors may have been closed, but God, you are the God of the open door. God, I thank you. You're going to open up doors for people. Jobs are coming, hallelujah. New scholarships are coming, praise God. Opportunities are coming that are about to blow your mind, because Jesus is bigger than any dream that you have. Raise up your hand and begin to praise God and thank God for Jesus tonight. God, I thank you for the healing of the mind, the healing of the body, the restoration of dreams. God, opening up doors, we give you praise. We call it done. And I'm glad tonight, Lord, we don't even have to feel anything, because miracles are not feeling based. They are faith based. And the just will live by faith. So I want you to raise your hand. You may have never done it before, but praise God like it's already done. Say, I receive it in the name of Jesus. I'm not going to let my feeling get in the way of faith. Glory to God. God, I praise you right now in the name of Jesus. There were three crosses on Golgotha's hill. A thief on either side, and only one made it to heaven with Jesus. The Bible said that the one thief on one side looked at Jesus and said, you're not the king. You don't look like a king. Save yourself. But the other man said, Jesus, I've messed up my life. I've made some bad choices. And he was about ready to die. He didn't have much strength left. But he said, Jesus, remember me. Somebody here tonight on Christmas Eve needs to say, Jesus, remember me. Friend, there is enough hell in this life without you dying and going to hell when you die. So who tonight would raise their hand and say, you know, on Christmas Eve, Jesus, it's go time for me. I want to know that I have a relationship. I'm right with you. And if I don't live to see 2017, I know that everything is going to be all right, because on Christmas Eve, I said, Jesus, remember me. Raise up your hand right now. Raise up your hand. He'll remember you. Yes, hands are going up all over this sanctuary tonight. And keep it up high. He said, Jesus, remember me. Jesus didn't say, you got to join a church. You got to change your clothes. You got to be religious. Jesus' answer was, today or right now, you will be with me in paradise. With that hand up, I want us all to pray this prayer all over the place, because people are about to say on Christmas Eve, not only remember me, but save my soul. Put my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. Lord, it's not about church. It's not about religion. But I need a relationship. Come on, I want everybody to shout it. Come on, to the baby Jesus, say thank you, Jesus, for coming to the manger, going to the cross, and coming out of the grave. Hell is not for me. Hell is not for me. I'm not going to hell for somebody else. I'm not going to hell for some friends. But tonight I make up my mind. I'm going to live for Jesus Christ, because I confess my sins and I receive by faith you, Jesus, as a Savior, a deliverer, a forgiver, and my King. So Jesus, save my soul. Put my name in the Book of Life. And I'll always remember that tonight on Christmas Eve, 2016, I ask Jesus to save my soul. I'm not lost, but I am saved. I need the church to shout this next sentence, because the Bible says, let the church shout it, because the Bible said, whoever calls on the name of the Lord, they shall be saved. So I know I'm saved. I'm glad I'm saved. And I'm going to tell the world that I'm saved. Would you take your hand and just give him a wave off of the praise tonight? It's about telling the world now. Oh, Jesus, there's a spirit in here. People want to tell the world what Jesus did. Come on, wave your hand and praise him, because he is the reason. I don't want you to sit down. Sometimes we brag on one another. We brag on a church. We brag on a preacher. We brag on a friend. And maybe that's okay. But how many believe on Christmas Eve we ought to brag about Jesus? Can I get some amens? We ought to be bragging about him tonight. So I want you to go up to at least three people and say this. I want you to say, Jesus is the best thing that ever happened to me. Come on, tell your people. Jesus is the best thing that ever happened to me. Listen, I like how you're saying it. You're saying it like you feel. He's the best thing that ever happened to me. Hallelujah. Tell you what, God is good. All the time. Boy, the devil lost some souls tonight. I said he took the one, he lost some souls. People walked in here and said, I've had it with the devil. Jesus is the reason for my season. And since you came to Jesus, the reason for the season, there's another song that says it's a new season. It's a new day. A fresh anointing's flowing my way. It's a season of power and prosperity. It's a new season. Now I want our ushers, if they would, let's thank God for our ushers. Folks are still coming into the service tonight, and we are thankful for every one of them. Put your hands together, give them a welcome and a praise the Lord tonight. Each and every one, those that are still in the lobby coming in, we say welcome to the Christmas Eve celebration for the King. For the King. Man, I like that. This feels good to say for the King. For the King. Look at somebody say it's for the King. Look at them and say it's for the King. It's for the King. It's for the King. Amen. It's for the King. I came to church for the King tonight. Amen. The worship team sang for the King tonight. Amen. People got saved because of the King tonight. Oh, it's all because of the King. Jesus. Well, I'll tell you what, there's so many people that are blessed here this evening. You can just feel it. And I always believe that God blesses his people for two reasons. Number one, because he loves them. How many are glad God loves you unconditionally? He loves you when you're not doing right. He loves you when you're doing right. Let's give a praise God for that. Man, he loves you when other people don't want to love you anymore. That's who God is. Thank you, God. God also blesses us because he knows there's a whole lot of other people that need blessings. Christmas Eve is a night where many times families will bring relatives and friends, and people will just maybe check out church because the time of the year it is. We don't care why you're here. We're just glad you're here tonight. We're just glad you're here. We're just glad you're here. No more, no less. Be what I'm saying. Of course, every Christmas Eve, I talk a little bit about the why of what we're about to do, because how many would agree with this statement? The world needs a whole lot of Jesus right now. Doesn't the world? I didn't say a whole lot of church or religion. I said Jesus. How many believe every street needs Jesus? Every city needs Jesus. How many believe every high school needs Jesus? I mean, we just need a whole lot of Jesus in this world. And you might say, well, I've been praying for you, Pastor, that, you know, the Lord will use you to get... No, how many know we all get Jesus out there? How many believe it's everybody's job to push Jesus, to share Jesus, to promote Jesus? And that's what I want to ask for your help on in a couple of minutes here tonight. But for the sake of our visitors, we've been here about, as an outreach church, we're celebrating about 22 years with a focus of community outreach. Our mission program is always home, always Wilmington, always Newcastle County, always the surrounding areas, always the places that other people don't want to go, always the other places where the guns are popping off at night like firecrackers and drug deals are going down on the corner. But guess what? I still believe that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. I'm just crazy enough to believe. Can I get some amens? That God is bigger than all of that drama and all that stuff we see on our television screen. So for the sake of our visitors tonight, especially, get on the bus with me. Get on the bus with me. This is one of our favorite videos that we compiled, all of our own footage over the many years. Get on the bus, leave Faith City, go down in these areas with us, and watch people line up on corners, not one, not two, but many times, 50, 70, sometimes 100 on one corner, and have to send the bus back twice. Sister April, raise your hand. You're one of our coordinators. How many times have you had to send that bus back twice to the same corner? How many know that's a good thing? Fill up the bus to go to church instead of filling up, come on, filling up the jails. Amen. I said amen tonight. And every time I see these young people, I say every one of them has a promise. Every one of them has a future. Every one of them has potential. When the devil sees the young people, he says, oh, well, I want to use them. But I believe if we can get the children, as the Bible said, train up the children in the way they should go, Proverbs 22:6. When they get old, they'll not depart from it. Maybe they'll stray. Maybe they'll go out and mess up for a while. But, you know, you don't have to raise your hand because we all been there. But how many ever strayed? I'll raise my hand. How many's ever strayed? But mom's prayers got you back, didn't they? And you know, you might have messed up for a while. But how many would raise your hand and say, your raising brought you back? You try to run, but they always say you can run, but you can't hide from God. And so the reason we're just like totally sold out, overtly committed to this initiative over 21 years now. Never missed a month in 21 years running buses. That's a miracle in itself. Somebody said, well, how did that happen? It happened one person at a time, you. One envelope at a time, you. People saying, you know what? All it takes for evil to prevail is for good people to do nothing. But I will not stand by and do nothing. I will do something, and I will make that difference. And I praise the Lord that after 21 years, some of these young people have graduated from high school, gone on to college, have great careers and jobs. I have at least three over the years that I've helped get into Bible school, and they're preaching the gospel today. They grew up in the hood. They grew up down where the drugs were. But Jesus doesn't care where you grow up. Come on, give me some amens. It doesn't mean anything to Jesus how bad the neighborhood is. All you have to do is have a little bit of faith and know that God can take you somewhere if you'll just believe. So tonight, in a couple of moments, our ushers will place in your hands a special envelope designed for tonight. And just all out with you, we're asking and praying that you'll be extremely generous. And even though maybe you may not be rich, I'm not rich, how many know we're blessed compared to other people in this world? When you look at that envelope, you won't look at the least you could do tonight. But you would say, you know what? I'm not gonna live forever anyway. How many know when you die, you're not taking anything with you except people to heaven and what you did for the work of the Lord? And so I'm asking you tonight to look at that envelope and say, you know what? I'm going to sow, whether it's on your credit, your debit, however, you can give all kinds of ways this evening. But we're asking that you would give extremely generous tonight because we have a good problem. What is a good problem? We have at least five new areas in the city of Wilmington who are asking us to come in with buses, to begin to go into the hood and begin to take people out of that environment and bring them to Faith City, to bring them out across from the Christiana Mall and let them know there is a better way, that there is a God who'll take you just as you are. Come on, say amen. Sometimes they get on the bus and they're high. Sometimes they get on the bus and they're drunk. But you know what? They come in here, and by the time the service is done, Jesus has done a transformation. Can I get some amens in here? What is Christmas all about anyway? Is it what's under the tree, or is it what's in the heart? So tonight I'm going to ask some people. I'm going to ask some people to dig down deep tonight. I'm asking some people because the only thing holding us, stopping us between getting more buses and running them is always the resources or the money. So I'm going to ask you tonight, some of you could give $100. Our prayer has been, some of us have been praying before year's end because there's only a few days left in the calendar year that you can give money for your tax purposes and donation purposes. We're praying that God would speak to 50 people before the end of the year and they would give a seed as great as $1,000, because the moment we have the resources, we're not afraid. Let's go. And let's take back what the devil stole. Let's get our kids with Jesus. Come on, say amen. So, Father, right now, I think that people feel what we're saying. I believe they see where we're looking. And all we're trying to do, Lord, is to reach as many souls as we can. Because there are many people who believe that we are living in the last days. Many people believe we're living in final hours. Jesus said in Matthew 24, when you see these days come upon you, when people call evil good and good evil, he said, look up, your redemption draweth nigh. When they asked Jesus, why do you seem so focused about your ministry, he said in John 9:4, I must work the works of him that sent me while it is day. The night is coming when no man can work. So God, I'm asking you, people will look at the envelope and say, yeah, you know what? I could use that $100 for something else. I could use that for something else. But I'm just going to sow it tonight, because this world is not my home. I'm just passing through. And I'm not so much concerned about success as I am about living a life of significance with eternal values. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. The ushers are coming out with these envelopes, and may the Lord bless you and lead you tonight. Together, we make a difference.
Sweet.
was on the hillside teaching in Luke chapter 6, verse 38. He knew that people would be tempted when they had opportunities to give, whether their finances or their time, their talent. He preached and he said, give, for it shall be given back to you. And the master said, it'll be given back to you, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. So tonight, as our ushers make their way to the altars, we're going to pray that God will not only use these resources to help us in the new year, reach more souls for Jesus Christ, connect more people to the power of the message of the cross, but we're also praying that God will bless you. I always believe that what you make happen for others, God can make happen for you. I believe if I help somebody else's child get saved, God will look out for my child. So Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for these opportunities to invest, to do things that live on after we're gone. And God, we pray that you would raise up a strong showing of support tonight, that we can continue reaching all over this community in the name that is above every name, the only name, Jesus. We dedicate all of it in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Before our ushers begin to come, if you are still filling out your information or giving whatever way you're giving tonight, they are happy just to wait for you, because every gift is important. Every envelope matters. You play an important part of bringing about resurrection. Ushers, thank you. God bless you as you pass these pens on Christmas Eve. Would you praise the Lord tonight? We are so blessed. What a treat. Thank you. Thank you. We are blessed. Very blessed. Just before we partake of Holy Communion, there is that unforgettable picture in our minds growing up of Mary, Joseph, a baby in a manger, very humble surrounding. There's so many life lessons you can learn from Christmas. So many life lessons you can learn from, could we call them the people of Christmas? One of them tonight we're going to pull out of the many before we share communion. And for a brief moment, we look at the life. Tonight we'll pick Mary. We can learn so much from the life of Mary on how to be a blessing to others this Christmas. Thus, I'd like to title this learning from the life of Mary on how to be a blessing this Christmas. And tonight, let us just say that you are truly a blessing by simply being here and worshiping and celebrating. But I'd like to share five very quick things out of the scripture that Mary had that made her such a standout person. And every one of those qualities she possessed are certainly qualities that you and I, through the help of the Lord Jesus Christ, can share this season and throughout the rest of the year and the coming year as well. First of all, Mary had a pure heart. It's so great to be around people who have pure hearts. People who do good things for the right reasons. People who don't give you things to try to manipulate you or control you or to set you up for some type of favor or payback. The Bible said this young lady had a pure heart. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 5 verse 8, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. She did not have a hidden agenda. When the angel visited her as a teenage girl and said, young lady, something is about to happen to you. You will become with child, but you will not know a man. She said, be it unto me according to thy word. God was looking for a young lady with a pure heart. Not trying to be a historical figure or somehow leave a legacy, but rather be a servant. Wasn't it Jesus who said, let the greatest among you become the servant of all? Wasn't it Jesus who, when the disciples went into the egotistical binge of saying, we will not get on our knees and wash anyone's feet, Jesus had to crash that situation and come into the room and grab a towel and a basin and get on his knees, and as the King of Kings, he washed their feet. He had a pure heart. The mother of Jesus had a pure heart. This Christmas season, may our hearts be pure. No agendas, no gain. Look at people in the eye when you talk to them. Remember, you're not better than anyone else, neither am I, except for the grace of God. It could be us. Whatever you do it with a pure heart. Another quality that Mary had was humility. If there was any young lady who could have somehow gotten the big head and some kind of attitude, it could have been her. Mary could have worked it, as they say. She could have worked what was happening to her. Imagine when she began to show. And even though there were some people that were making up all kinds of stuff, saying no way that God is in that womb. But if she was an egotistical person, she could have worked it somehow to her advantage. But how many are glad that the mother of Jesus was a humble woman? Luke chapter 1, verse 46. And Mary said, my soul doth magnify the Lord, not me. And my spirit hath rejoiced in God, my Savior. Look, always others focused. For he hath regarded the low estate of his handmaiden. She said, I'm nobody special. I'm just a handmaiden. For behold, from henceforth all generations shall call me blessed. For he that is mighty hath done to me great things. And holy is whose name? Somebody say it tonight. Is his name. Finally we read, and his mercy is on them that fear him from generation to generation. A teenage girl talking like a young woman beyond her years, saying, there's nothing special about me. I am honored to be chosen by God and to be his hands extended. Would you do this for a second? Come on, please do it. Take your hands and hold them out in front of you right now. No, please do it. I'm serious. Do it and say, these hands are God's hands extended. Look at those hands and say, if these hands get any credit, the glory goes to God. For without him, I can do nothing. Did you really mean that tonight? And that was the heart of Mary. Number one, Mary had a pure heart. Secondly, she showed humility. Third of five tonight, Mary was available. If we're going to be a blessing, the greatest ability that a human being can possess is availability. Lord, I'm available to you. Mary could have, when that angel showed up, she could have said, you know what, this is not for me. There's a whole lot of other girls, you know, in the town. Why don't you go talk to them, show up to them? But she, listen to this, she said, whatever God wants, I am available. How many believe we will miss out on some blessings if we don't say, Lord, I'm available to you? How many believe that when God shows up and he has something for you to do? How many know that it's not just so that you can be a blessing to somebody, but how many believe there just might be a blessing in it for you? And so she said, I'm available. She had availability in Luke chapter 1. Verse 38, and Mary said, behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And then that angel departed from her. And then Mary had another quality. She trusted and obeyed God. Sometimes it's hard to trust God when you don't understand, isn't it? Sometimes it's hard to keep one foot in front of the other, walking by faith, when people have their opinions and people are saying things. And it seems like the harder you pray and the more you read your Bible and the more you try to stay connected to Jesus, the more your world keeps falling apart. But I'm here to tell you tonight, there's nothing in your life that God didn't know about already. There's nothing in your life this Christmas that Jesus cannot handle. And so like Mary, when she said, how in the world am I going to have a baby? I'm not even married. I don't even know a man. She had to step up by faith and say, God, I don't understand it, but I trust you. There's somebody in this service tonight going through some hell right now. I'm telling you, raise up your hand and say, Lord, I trust you. Lord, I trust you. I don't understand why the doctor gave me the diet. I don't understand why I'm going through this trauma. Somebody raise your hand and say, I'm going to trust the Lord. I'm going to trust the Lord. And then not only did she trust God, but it says she obeyed. Luke chapter 1, verse 34 and 35. Then said Mary unto the angel, how shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, the Holy Ghost. She had never met the Holy Ghost. How many know that took faith? The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. God will tell you things sometimes you don't understand. But how many know you got to walk by faith and not by sight? Some of you, God has been talking to you this Christmas season. God has been revealing things, and the devil's saying, don't believe it. It's too out there. God can't do it. When God decides to do it, no devil in hell can stop God from showing up in your situation. So I'm telling you tonight, somebody needs to raise your hand right now and say, God, I will trust you and I will obey you. Come on, you know who you are. Raise up your hand and say, God, I trust and obey. And he'll ask you sometimes to get out of the boat and walk on the water like he did with Peter. But Peter had to trust and obey. Somebody said, yeah, what's the rest of the story? You better tell everybody, Pastor, that Peter, when he trusted and obeyed, he went out on the water and he began to sink. He began to almost drown. Yeah, but let me tell you the rest of the story. Just when they thought they lost him, Jesus reached down and picked him up out of the water. Just when you think you're going to lose it all, just when you think you're going to go crazy, just when you think your world is about to crash, Jesus will reach down. I feel the Holy Ghost right now. He will reach down and pick up somebody. Somebody ought to praise the Lord right now in here. Well, I thank God for Mary. I thank God for what she teaches us. And then finally, number five, Mary had endurance. She had endurance. Mary began a marathon. Jesus was born. She raised him, her and Joseph. Took him to the temple. Some of us don't remember that it was Mary, just typical mom. How many thank God for your mother that encouraged you to do things? You ever have a mom say, go on and try it. Go on. Your friends say you can't, but go on. How many thank God for mothers that encourage you? And so, do you know that Mary encouraged Jesus to perform his very first miracle? It was in John chapter 2. Our final text tonight, and the third day there was a marriage in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. And both Jesus was called and his disciples to the marriage. And when they wanted wine, the mother of Jesus, Mary, said unto him, Jesus, they have no wine, son. Jesus saith unto her, woman, or, you know, this is King James, but in today he said, mom, what? Mom, don't bug me right now. What have I to do with you? Mine hour, my ministry has not yet begun. But here comes good mother Mary. His mother saith unto the servants, you know what? Don't listen to him. Whatsoever he saith unto you, just do what he says. She knew that God was about to show up. Jesus saith unto them, see? Jesus, the Spirit came on and God came on and he said, take those water pots and fill them with water. And they filled them up to the brim. And he saith, Jesus saith unto them, draw out now, pour what's in those, and bear unto the governor of the feast. And they began to bear it or pour out the liquid that was in there. And when the ruler of the feast had tasted the water that was made, what does the church say tonight? Was made what? Shout it. That was because Mary, the mother of Jesus, got involved and said, listen, Jesus, just go on. You're called of God. Go on and do your first miracle. And look what happened. The ruler of the feast tasted the water. It was made wine. Knew not whence it was, but the servants drew the water and knew. The governor of the feast called the bridegroom. This beginning of miracles did Jesus in Cana of Galilee, and manifested forth his glory, and his disciples believed on him. Mary not only had endurance to take him to the temple to train him, not only had endurance to encourage him to say, get going, Jesus, and turn the water into wine. You can do this. But she also showed up at the very end when he hung on the cross. And Jesus looked down in his bloody state, said to his brothers, look out for mom. And he looked at Mary and he said, woman, mom, behold thy son. The one she held in her arms, carried in her womb, she watched him battered and mistreated. She had endurance. As the ushers are coming to the stations of the altar tonight to prepare us for Holy Communion on Christmas Eve, what were these five amazing qualities that Mary had that we all need all throughout the year? First of all, Mary had a pure heart. Secondly, Mary showed humility. God is looking for people that will give Him the glory. You want God to bless you more? Give Him the praise for whatever good happens in your life. Thirdly, Mary was available. If you'll say one of my New Year's resolutions is to be available to God, some of you might have been saying, you know what, I've been praying, Pastor, and I'm just believing that God is going to make my latter days greater than my former. How many believe that God can help you finish strong in your life? Can I see some hands? How many believe that the latter part of your life can be greater than the former? If you want to experience that next level, you learn from Mary and make yourself available. Number four, Mary trusted and obeyed God. And finally, number five, Mary had endurance. Some of you came tonight, you've been going through some really, really tough times. But I'm here to tell you, don't give up. Be like Mary. Trust in God and obey Him. And I promise you this, you're coming out on the other side. You will not drown. You will survive and you will thrive. In the name of Jesus. Do you thank God for His word? And Mary, let's put our hands together. Thank you, Jesus, for your mother, Mary. I'd like to invite you to stand. Would you do that right now as we prepare for Holy Communion? And if you're visiting tonight, we make communion just very, very simple, but yet personal. What we ask is that when the worship begins, that you simply, as the ushers will direct you, come to the front, receive the elements of communion, the blood and the body, but hold on to them, don't take them, and just enjoy the powerful atmosphere of worship as we focus on the King. And I feel led to say this, communion time many times is miracle time. It's empowerment time. Get ready for power to come into your life. Let us begin to come to the communion table at this time.
Every song.
became another scene. That amazing painting of the Last Supper was now a grown man that we saw once lay in a manger with Mary and Joseph. He is holding a time of fellowship with his disciples, and all of a sudden the format changes and Jesus stands and he says, "The bread that we're about to have for supper, called it the Last Supper," he said, "I want to do something else with the bread." He said, "I want you to break it into small pieces and begin to share it around the table." And as they did it, he said, "This is the lie of it all." He says, "In a moment, we're going to take it together." And he says, "When you take this bread, you do so in memory of the Lord's sufferings." He began to say that very soon, "I'm going to go and be crucified. I'm going to fulfill my destiny." Then he said, "As oft as you do this," he was inferring, "we're never to stop having communion because it reminds us of the Lord's sufferings." And he says, "You do it in remembrance of me." And so tonight, we have gathered around the table, as it were, many of us, and we have obeyed Jesus by taking our piece of the bread, which through faith is his body. And when we take it together in just a moment, we are taking and partaking of the Lord's suffering. But let me remind you, you're doing more than just remembering, and you're doing more than just partaking, but you are a recipient of the resurrection power of Jesus. You need to be reminded tonight that when he said it is finished, and they took him off the cross, at that moment his body was dead. But you need to be reminded that it was 3 days later that Jesus fulfilled the prophecy when he said, before he died, "No man takes my life. They're not killing me." He said, "I lay it down willingly." And he said, "If I lay it down, I will raise it back up again." The reason it's huge for us to celebrate that tonight is because when this goes into your physical body, the resurrection power of Jesus goes into your body. It goes into your mind. It goes into the cells of your body. It goes into your mind. I'm talking about resurrection power. That means if you walked in here feeling broke down, you can walk out feeling resurrected. That means if you walked in here feeling like giving up on life, you can walk out resurrected, saying that today is the first day of the rest of my life with Jesus Christ. I'm not giving in to my loss. I'm not giving in to my pain. I'm not giving in to my sickness. I'm not giving in to my trauma nor my past, because the same Jesus that overcame death is now living in me. And I say, as you take this tonight, it will cause you to leave this place as an overcomer and not a victim. So are you ready tonight? Jesus said, "Take this bread, for it is my body." Let us now take the body of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, right now. Thank God. Devil, you're not going to hold me back. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody praise the Lord for a second. Hallelujah. Devil, you're not going to hold anybody back. Thank you, Jesus is alive and well, and he's living in us. Praise God. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Thank you, Jesus. I feel God's power moving right now. Miracles are taking place. Somebody with a heart condition, God's healing you right now. That means God's going in there what the doctor could not finish. The great physician is a miracle worker. Hallelujah. I speak a word over you. You will live and not die and declare the works of the Lord. God has a call on your life, and God is not done with you. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus raised up the cup, and he said, "This cup represents my blood, which is about to be shed for you. For without the shedding of blood, there can be no remission nor forgiveness of sin. I say it every time we have communion, what can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. My past is not my present and not my future, because the blood has washed me clean. Can I get an amen in here? Maybe you did some bad stuff. Maybe we all did some bad things. But I'm here to tell you, the blood makes you clean tonight. Oh, somebody ought to praise him right now. And I believe when you take the blood, God's going to heal you in your body, heal you in your mind, heal you from your past. Maybe you were abused. Maybe somebody tried to ruin your life when you was a child. But I need to tell you, he's a healing Jesus tonight. And the blood will cover you. Glory to God. Let us right now, come on, get ready for a miracle. Somebody raise your hand and get ready for a miracle. I'm telling you, we serve a miracle God here. We serve a miracle Jesus. And I believe when you take the blood, the miracle power of God is going to flow down from your head to the bottom of your feet. Let us now take the blood of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're going to start praising God as loud as you want to. Glory to God. Go ahead and shout the victory right now in the name of Jesus. The devil thought he had you, but he didn't have anything. Come on, somebody needs to lift up your voice and praise God. Somebody needs to shout, I have the victory. Who's the devil think he is anyway? To try to poke your life. To try to hijack your future. Oh, come on, praise him in the house of God tonight. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God, we give you praise. Somebody give him a wave off. You know God is taking care of it tonight. God is taking care of it. In the name of Jesus. So now, not even breaking the flow of the move of God, the ushers, yes, ushers. The Bible said in Matthew 5:16, we're talking about light. Jesus said, you are the light of the world. Look at somebody, say, I'm a light. Come on, testify. Say, I'm a light. Look at them, tell them, say, you are a light. Jesus didn't say, he didn't say the church was the light. He didn't say the preacher was the light. He didn't say the denomination was the light. He said, you are the light of the world. How many know we need to let our light shine for Jesus all the time? So the candles are going out right now. We're going to get ready to let our little light shine. Oh, God is good. Does somebody lift your voice and give him a shout right now? Hallelujah. Ushers, do the best you can by moving in the Spirit. Glory to God. As soon as you get that candle, I need everybody to remain standing. Because this is how we always close every year. Christmas Eve. As soon as you get that candle, twist the top of it. And I pray the battery's still working. Amen. Brother Joe changed all of them over the last 2 weeks. Took him 2 weeks to change the batteries. I hope he did a good job this year. Oh, praise God. Praise God. Then take it, hold it up. Look at that. If your arm gets tired, switch to the other one. We're going to be lights. We're going to be lights. We're going to listen. We're going to let our little light shine when we're going through the valley. Our light's going to shine when we don't have nothing to shine about. Because the reason that we can shine is because greater is he that is in us than he that's in the world. And I need everybody, maybe you are rhythmically challenged. Maybe your school teacher said you are rhythmically challenged. But I want us to kind of get a sway going. Come on, say. Oh. Left to right, oh, left to right, oh, oh, move it left to right, oh, silence, think silent. Thank you. to the world. The Lord is come. Let us receive the King. The jewels are set. Show to the world. The Lord is come. Let us receive the King. Let everyone prepare the road. Let heaven meet your state. Let heaven meet your state. Let your heaven. church? Well, you better believe it. At 8 a.m., 10 a.m., and noon, he's coming soon. And after every service, we're having a free fellowship breakfast with waffles and hot stew and butter and fruit. Some fresh coffee and orange juice. Oh yes, we want you here tomorrow. So whether 8, 10, or noon, come on out and celebrate the birthday. Oh, and we're going to have a happy birthday Jesus cake. Every service, the big cake rolls down the aisles, the sparklers. Oh my, it's a birthday celebration. Bring the whole family tomorrow. Good night. God bless you. And make sure you don't take your candle with you. If you want to take your candle, it's only $100 donation. Oh, they won't take them now. We wish you a Merry Christmas. much we want to say to those who have arrived thus far, welcome and a big old Merry Christmas. We're excited that you're here tonight because it's all about Jesus. It's so awesome how Christmas is falling this year on the weekend, and we can make sure that in the middle of the gifts and the presents and the family and the friends, that we can put the number one reason, and his name is J-E-S-U-S. You know what would be so cool, because folks will be coming in for a few moments. Why don't you reach out to two or three folks around you across the aisle and say, Jesus is the reason for the season. Come on, try that on. Let us fill the room with people saying, Jesus is the reason for the season. Come on, say it everywhere. Jesus is the reason for the season. But tell somebody else, Jesus is the reason for the season. Oh, yes. The devil's in trouble, because when God's people come together and lift up a praise, how many believe we're in a room where miracles can happen tonight? I said, how many believe we're in a room where miracles can happen tonight?